Hello friends, today we are going to see what is coefficient of thermal conductivity and how, what is the formula for coefficient of thermal conductivity. How the coefficient of thermal conductivity, what is the formula we are going to get. Today we are going to discuss everything, okay. Coefficient of thermal conductivity, okay. So that is like a conduction of one place to another place, that is a coefficient of thermal conductivity, okay. So heat transferring with respect to the time, that we can take it as the main term, heat transferring with respect to the rate of change of heat with respect to the time. If more area is there, okay, the conductivity will be more. So that means directly proportional to area, okay. Another thing, it's a temperature gradient, okay. What is a temperature gradient? Changing the temperature with respect to the length, okay. So that is called temperature gradient, okay. Changing temperature gradient also, it's important, okay. So heat transferring, it's a T by DL. It's a temperature gradient, temperature changing with respect to the length, okay. And heat transferring is depend on the two factor. One is the area of the metal, and another thing, it's a temperature, changing temperature with respect to the length, okay. So directly proportional I want to remove, okay. Just you can include with the constant. Whenever you are removing directly proportional, you can include the constant. Here K is going to represent as the coefficient of thermal conductivity. A dt by dl is equal to dq by dt, okay. Heat energy changing with respect to the time, it is a area, and it is a temperature coefficient. It is a temperature coefficient. Temperature gradient, okay. Temperature changing with respect to the length, temperature gradient, and it is a area, and it is a heat, rate of change of heat, that we can take it as the power, okay. So rate of change of heat, we can take it as a power. K is equal to dq by dt divided by a dt by dl, okay. So it is a temperature, it is a length, it is a area, it is a heat, it is a time, okay. So this together we can take it as a watt. And this together we can take it as its area, length into breadth, it is a meter square, okay. Temperature we can take it Kelvin, it's a length, we can take it as a meter. So this meter square get cancelled, okay. The SI unit of temperature coefficient will be watt, from meter plus 1 I am taken as a numerator, so meter minus 1. Kelvin also I am taken as a numerator, Kelvin minus 1. This is a total SI unit of coefficient of thermal conductivity. Thank you.